Hello, everyone. Welcome back to the pre-event press conference for Master Shanghai. We are joined by DRG. We'll start with a few pre-submitted questions and then move on to remote media questions. First question goes to either of the players from the Valorant competitive community. How has the addition of Xion 7 to the roster revitalized the team?
Sorry, what's roster? How?
How
Sorry, could
has,
you please?
oh yep, yeah. How has the addition of Xion 7 to the roster revitalized the team?
在这个问题，两个选手都可以回答。你们觉得当顺其来到我们的队伍之后，来到了现在新的整体的一个人员，你们觉得现在的新阵容怎么样呢？两个人都可以回答。
我觉得他来到这边的话，整个阵容就是会比较多变吧，就是可以尝试更多的适合我们的打法，然后也不会像以前那样的保守跟常规阵容，我们可以尝试去做更多的新东西。
除了阵容上，可能再多一点是队伍的默契上，其实有更好的风格吧，因为它挺适合我们队伍风格的，然后在我们做任何的决定的时候，都挺有默契的。
And so Nick said feels like he will take more with the Shuai Qi getting to our team will have more changes and we can change to more play styles in the game and feel like sometimes when he joined to our team and bring some new thing and new style to our team and Luke said not only just the composition of more change it's more about Shuai Qi has adjusted well in our team and his play style is just really fit our play style our team's play style we can not only just play really safe and we can try some aggressive things in the game that's all
Thank you very much. Next question goes to either of the players. How does it feel to be an Ascension team on a main stage like Shanghai?
这个问题也是两位都可以回答。那其实我们是从晋升赛上打上来的，但是我们现在进入了上海的大师赛，现在感受怎么样？
感受怎么样嘛？我觉得会比竞争赛稍微激动一点嘛。因为竞争赛是拿到联赛名额嘛，但是这个就不一样，这是世界赛，就能到世界舞台上展现自己的很好的机会。
我觉得，参加完竞争赛，然后到这边打世界赛，心情主要是多一点是激动嘛，因为我们终于有机会可以证明我们五个人的实力，然后可以在世界上的舞台展现自己，然后心情是挺兴奋的。
Nick said feels like more exciting than Ascension because when we was in Ascension feels like we are just qualified for the VCT, but now on the world stage, it's a great opportunity for all of us to present what we got. And Luke said, feels like compared with Ascension, we're just getting more excited about the world stage because this is a chance to prove all of us. We got the ability and we got the power to worth this world stage. And it's a great chance for us to present ourselves too. That's all. Thank you.
Thank you very much. We'll now transition to on-site media questions.
我觉得我们这次的目标就是过来吸取经验的，所以没有说要拿到多好的成绩，大家尽力而为吧，打出自己的风采就可以了。
第一次参加世界赛，我们队最主要就像 Nick 说的，除了吸取经验，再就是学习国外的风格是什么样子的。因为我们一直以来都是参考欧美赛区的阵容啊，或是他们的游戏节奏， 我们都在尽力的学习他们，然后这次终于有机会跟他们是当敌人的方式去进行比赛。我觉得不论输赢，就只要享受好比赛，然后享受这个舞台。
这个问题提问到两位选手，那也是在你自己熟悉的主场作战吗？那对战，是压力更多一点，还是动力会更多一些？
对我来说应该是动力会多一点吧，因为在自己主场嘛，认识的人也多，支持的人也多，就是把自己最好的一面展示给他们就行了。
我觉得当一个职业选手，压力就是一个动力吧，因为喜欢你的很多，讨厌你的人也很多，然后再就是把这些，不管是喜欢或讨厌，把它转换成，就是你前进的动力吧，然后尽力的去打好每一回合，打好每一场比赛。
谢谢。这里问到 Nick 选手，然后这是 DRG 第一次进入到大师赛，然后这次面对 TH，他们也是有一个临时的变阵，那对你们的备战是否会有什么影响？
我觉得这对我们来说算是一种，很好展示自己的机会吧。因为他们的主力选手明尼普不在嘛，那我们就是看能不能有个针对性的打法去面对他们。那我们也是在好好的训练跟复盘，对。
So the question is, this time on the Swiss stage, you were faced against the heretics, and their rules have changed a little bit. Will this change affect your team preparation? And Nick's answer was that I think this is actually a chance for us to face against them because the absence of Mini Boo feel like we can play something that targets on our opponent, and we have done our training and we have already reviewed the pre-match, so we have done the preparation like that. That's all. Thank you.
Um, 我想问问你们，Vukasho 选手的中文怎么样？你们是怎么沟通啊？How's Vukasho's Chinese? How do you guys communicate in the game?
他的中文现在还在学习，不是那么好。那我们在队内就是一些简单的英文交流。那 Luke 通常会帮我翻译，
你们都会说英文吗？
一点点。
那你怎么办？如果有问题的时候，你们怎么解决？
有问题的话，我们是有翻译的，就是我们在复盘的时候会有翻译在旁边。
谢谢。
And so a question we already know, and Nick's answer is that Vukasho is still learning Chinese. He just can say in some basic and simple Chinese. So in the game, probably we just communicate with English, and I'm the IGO, and Luke will translate it for me. And Insu asked that if so how do you communicate if all of you speak English? And Nick said just a little bit, but if we have questions, we when we are doing our reviewing of the matchup, we will have translator for that. That's all. Thank you.
Thank you very much. We'll now take a few questions from remote media. First question from Pedro.
Yes, got a question for anyone that can answer. Well, as what was said earlier on in the press conference, it's a major achievement for an accession team to make it to the Masters event, not even the first year in their trajectory in an international league. And so my question to you guys is for you guys to continue the momentum from winning Ascension in China to then continue to fight amongst the best within your region. What do you think is the one thing that helped this team just improve so much to get to this point?
其实第二季从晋升赛开始就获得了进入我们 VCT CN 的名额嘛，包括到现在你们也是一路征战，也是进入到了象征着我们赛区最好的战队吧，因为你们进入到大师赛嘛。你觉得这个过程中你们最大的进步，你们是提升了哪一部分才能做到这么好的呢？两个人都可以回答这个问题。
我觉得进步上最大的是原本的我们那三个人的，不论是就是除了游戏内的进步，我觉得最大的进步是情绪上吧，还有游戏队伍的气氛上，因为我们五个人从晋升赛打上来，其实剩下的就我们这3、4个人，然后我们除了游戏内、游戏外，我们其实一直在学习怎么和队友们相处，然后尽量把游戏内和游戏外的默契都达到最好。因为这样才能充分的表达我们游戏内的东西。
So Luke's answer was that, except the things we in game, we think like it's more the process is mainly about our mentality and environment in our group. So from the ascension, actually there was roster changes. It's only three or four of us still in the team. So basically, for this time, for all along this time, we're just trying to like get along with our teammates, no matter in game or in our normal life. And we're trying to communicate with each other like better. And now we just cooperate better in the game. That's all. Thank you.
Thank you. Next question from Adley via LRGG.
Hi, so for both of you, Nick and Luke, you both moved over from the Taiwan and Hong Kong region back in Asia Pacific. How has the transition been for you guys? And now we are seeing more representation of the Taiwanese and Hong Konger players in China with Berlin, Yu, and others. Do you see more players from the region moving over to China? And how has it been seeing the region itself separated from China in terms of performance as well as playstyle?
其实之前两位选手也是在别的，包括说就是其他的类似于赛区的地方有打过嘛，也是现在来在我们 CN 赛区建立之后，也是来到了我们 CN 赛区。那就是其实现在可以看到有更多来自我们两岸的友好同胞都来到了我们的 VGTCN 来跟我们一起来打比赛嘛。其实大家可能说在打法风格上会不会有一些不同？那你觉得如何看待有越来越多的我们这些融入和加入？如何看待我们这些打法风格上面是不是有一些不同和融合？
我可以不回答吗？对，
可以，
这里。
可以的。Sorry about that. They don't really want to talk about this topic.
Alright, sorry.
Sorry.
Thank you. Next question. I'm sorry, I can't read your name. It starts with a B.
你好，二位，能听到我说话吗？
喂。
喂，你好，好的，
哎，
我的问题
可
是
以。
好的，我想问二位都可以回答这个问题啊。24号是要面对到咱们的劲敌 TH 了，他们最近也是经历了一些临场的这个改动，那么仍然对我们来讲是一场硬仗啊。想请问队员们为了这一战都做了哪一些的准备呢？心理上或者说从战术上都可以给我们讲一讲吗？
我们做了，我们首先有去观察他们的比赛，以及做阵容上的调整，就是无论是角色啊那些的，我们都会有去做一些新的布置，以便我们打出更好，展现出更好的东西吧。对。
除了战术上，在队伍的训练的方向，其实都和以前也会比较不相同、不相不一样。因为以前练的就是把基本功练好，那现在来大师赛可能换阵容，所以我们还针对了阵容去调整。然后再就是心态上，教练也是告诉着我们，就是我们以学习的心态来打这场比赛，然后就是把每件事情像以前一样做好每一个基本功，然后去打每一回合。谢谢。
好，谢
And
谢。
so the question, oh, thank you. So the question is that is for both of the players, Nick and Luke. And on the 21st, you will face against the Heretics. Actually, they got a roster change recently, but still a really kind of seems like a really hard fight for all you guys. So how was your preparation, no matter on mentality or strategy? And Nick's answer is that we have watched their pre-matches, and to target with that, we have some adjustment about our comps to present a better play form in the game. And looks at besides the strategy, we have changed our method of training. Like before the Master Shanghai, we were training more like basic things, but for the Master Shanghai, we have some new comps and prepared for that. And not only that, we think we have some preparation about our mentality, because this time we came to Master Shanghai, I think we are the challenger. We come here to learning new things. So, and our coach just told us that just do our basic things and play our own thing to like play every round like well. Thank you. That's all.
Thank you very much. That's all the time we have today with DRG. We'll be back with TH shortly.